Hey everybody, it's Missy MacWorry with morethanjustavocalcoach.com. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe. Please hit like. If there are any videos you'd like me to react to, leave it in the comments section below. And if you want to sign up for vocal lessons with me, follow the link in the description to my website where I have subscription content available. And if you don't like kitties, this is not the channel for you. This is not the channel for you, but if you love kitties, this is the channel for you. Okay, today I am following through on a special request for Greta Van Fleet. I know that the singer is really incredible, and I know that the musicianship is really strong because I've heard some Greta Van Fleet, but I don't know this song. So let's go on this journey, and I'm looking forward to it. Let's listen to Greta Van Fleet. Here we go. Looking forward to it. Like Freddie Mercury right here. I obviously recognize that he doesn't sound like Freddie Mercury, who is one of the greatest rock singers of all time. Is he the greatest? He might be. Leave your thoughts on that in the comments below. Obviously, this is an amazing vocalist with a very interesting timbre to his voice. That's all I have to say about that. I'm gonna shut up. Let's keep listening. Sessions. This is Renfest sessions. Like, this is Renfest. You know what I'm saying? I had to pause and just say that the arrangement is really cool and sparse, which allows the singer's voice to step forward. It's very nice. We'll be right back. to say, as a person who appreciates Jimmy Page's playing, I know a lot of people feel like Greta Van Fleet kind of ripped off Led Zeppelin. That is not John Bonham style drumming happening right there. One. And two, as much as that riff was very Page-esque, first of all, it was not sloppy enough to be Jimmy Page. The beauty of this band is the way they'll throw in a lick like that that is so, it just reminds you so much of like Zeppelin 3 or something, and then immediately pull you out of it just with a little piano riff. That little bluesy pop piano riff pulled it right away from that. So those combinations of things make them so special. Oh, he is, okay, let's keep going. John Paul Jones does not play piano like that. Man, that was so cool. Okay, Josh Kiska? I don't know. I knew that they were mostly brothers in this band. Wow. I remember seeing them way back when they first came out. I don't know if it was Highway Tuner. I don't know. Whatever one of their first songs was. I feel like his vocal control is so much better than what I remember. When I first heard them, that was awesome. He really, it's like he has the vocal control of Freddie Mercury. I don't think he sounds like him at all. He reminds me of a combination of like the skill set of Freddie Mercury with Geddy Lee and Robert Plant and had a baby and there he is, Josh Kiska. Please correct me, I'm sorry if I'm saying that wrong. He is really incredible. Yeah, that like higher timbre to his voice. So, timbre of a person's voice. All that really means is the way he sings a note. Person's voice is the personality of a person's voice. And I think that what people appreciate about Josh slash Geddy Lee slash Robert Plant slash Freddie Mercury is that unique personality in the voice. You could hear him sing Jingle Bells and you would know who it was. Jingle Bells. Anyway, he really has a unique timbre, kind of like a thinner, brighter, more forward sound to his voice and those growls that he does. Let me see if I can find one. I am looking for a growl. In my search, I found this and just want to say, this is an example of when I say Freddie Mercury like control, just really solid control over the notes and the pitches. Accuracy there, just beautiful. Awesome. is like the card carrying Josh Grell right there. And he reintroduces it periodically in this, and it's just glorious, isn't it? Nicely done. It's like I was just doing a Haley Reinhart video, and she's an incredible singer. And for those Greta Van Fleet fans who maybe don't know who she is, really incredible, soulful, jazzy singer. But this reminds me of her Joe Cocker moments. I call it Joe Cocker moments. He's having his Joe Cocker moment right here. It's so good. That is just classic. That growl. Wait, let me hear him. It's really cute. It's cute, but it's also very awesome. Not sure at all what he's saying there, but I did hear broken bells and one eye and anyway, just really well executed, nice grit, that little there are various ways to add distortion and grit, and that's just kind of a classic growl. And as I'm listening to him, you know, it's not all forward placement. It's just that his timbre is so unique. It's the folds themselves. So like, let's just talk about what defines that, what makes it so special. I mean, it is the folds themselves, the thickness or thinness of the folds, in this case, maybe. The thickness of the folds, the thinness of the folds, the placement of the larynx, not always as high as I was originally thinking. When I went back and looked at this, I realized, you know, it doesn't always have a super forward placement, but sound placement in the resonator, this is the body of your guitar right here. When the larynx is higher, it kind of creates a thinner sound, and he definitely has a bit of twanginess, which means a little bit more forward sound. Broken bells! Broken bells! Broken bells! These are just different sound placements. The broken bells! Broken bells! Would be like really up in the nose, too much twang, too much of a good thing. No, it's not a good thing. Too much nasality. This is something you want to look out for. I don't see any issue with his placement, but he's leaning more forward in his sound placement. And when you do that, and na 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 ma 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 ma, those are more forward placed sounds just by the nature of making those sounds. And if you're kind of experimenting with finding a more forward placement, that's how you do that. Because of the nasality, you cannot make an N or an M sound. Bum, 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 na, 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 na. You have to be more nasal in order to create the sounds. But that doesn't mean you need to live all the way up in there. There's a little bit more forward twang there, but it's not all there. It's definitely pulling down and forward. I always tell people to picture the sound coming down through here. His resonator, it's just about where he's placing the sound, the placement of the larynx. A lot of the time, you know, maybe being a little bit higher placement, which shortens the tract and the space to reverberate, essentially. His sound really is dictated by the folds, the placement of the larynx, the size of the larynx, the thickness or thinness of the folds, and ultimately the relaxed reverberation within his resonator. All of these things are defining his tone, his timbre, and it makes it so special. I mean, just want to say he has obviously great breath control, really great breath control. You can see that he's very calm through here. A lot of rock singers hold a lot of tension up in here, and you do not see any of that. He just totally has control. I see a little bit of jaw tension before in the little section before he went into that growl. Man, Josh is such an incredible singer with so much control, and I really appreciate that this was suggested. I have not listened to Greta Van Fleet in forever. I've never heard this song, and what a beautiful arrangement where each part gets accentuated with the drums. There's a lot of space, and you have moments where you can appreciate every instrument, the vocals, the lead guitar, the acoustic, the piano. How could you not appreciate Renfest in this video? Awesome, such an amazing song. Such an amazing band, such an incredible vocalist. I'm not sure what he did from the first time I heard him years ago to now, but I feel like he has worked on his voice because I think he has much more control than I remember in seeing him perform previously. So Greta Van Fleet fans, thank you for coming along with me on this journey. I really, really appreciate y'all, your likes. Please subscribe. Please visit my website. And if there are any videos you'd like me to react to, leave it in the comment section below. Peace.